by
Johanna,
aka Joe Tiffer, and live from the 36th Case Communication Congress in Leipzig. All talks at Congress are live translated between English and German and to one additional language. Visit c3lingo.org for more details and information how to access the streams. We appreciate your feedback. Please use the hashtag c3t. Your translation and this talk are provided by Qi, YT, and OS 10000. In this talk, we now warmly welcome Ling Johanna. Hello, everyone. Nice that all of you have made your way here. And especially if there's many people on the demonstration, happy that you still made it here. My focus, my talk is going to be a bit nervous at the moment. My talk is divided into three parts.
Und zwar werde ich so, im Allgemeinen was
the first one is going to be generally about connected mobility, which is divided in different areas.
Das eigentliche Projekt, was ich gerade dabei bin zu initiieren, das Digital Bike 23. Und,
the Digital Bike 23. And then I'm going to be about the sub-project e-bike brain.
Was jetzt auch dem, was ich demnächst in Berlin beginne.
Which I will be soon starting in Berlin.
Ja, zur Connected Mobility.
For the Connected Mobility.
Also erstmal wollte ich fragen, gibt
so
es
first of all,
Leute, die schon mal E-Bikes gefahren sind?
I wanted to know if there's anybody in the audience who rode E-Bikes before. Yeah, that looks differently. That's much different from before. So, who's actually worked on one?
Okay. Weil ich hatte auch einen Vortrag,
because I already had a talk, the first one that I made was 2007 by Gizmo, also pretty good talk.
Und beschäftigt sich jemand professionell?
And you want to know if professionally anybody was doing e-bikes.
Okay, super.
Oh wow, great. Good.
Dann starte ich mal los. Erstmal geht es jetzt so ein bisschen... Kurzer Einblick in die,
so first this is going to be a bit about
in der Connected Mobility,
what's happening in Connected Mobility. It's currently developed on many areas in parallel, quite chaotic and fast and uncoordinated. Many things are being trying to be connected. But the problem that we are creating for ourselves, what many studies actually predict, is that we are stepping back to the automotive time, because the focus of the big industry, automotive and the tech industry, is on automotive. It's like this, the technology industry tried to build cars and you could say that they actually failed. The automotive companies, they were very late and now they've caught up and now they're teaming up and focusing a lot on autonomous driving. The issue of mobility is, of course, as I said, it's predicted since a long time, is that there are highly covered, very high covered costs. For example, the server costs, the communication and transfer costs. That is very hard to predict. The mobility will create lots and lots of data because the cars are communicating amongst each other. They're communicating with the environment. This data has to be administered. It must be transferred on servers, and a good network needs to be built for this. And the issue is, of course, between all of these, there's still us users who
oder nicht aus Versehen
unintentionally need to be connected within. And then the question is, where is our position in this entire networking chaos?
Ich wollte, also ich will den diesen Teil jetzt in drei Bereiche einteilen.
So I wanted to divide this part into three parts. So the first part is the autonomous driving itself, the second part Mobility as a Service, and then I wanted to give the example of e-scooters, which we are seeing since 2017. Within autonomous driving in the freight transport, there have been many trials. This is a trial from Daimler, which drove in 2015 through the test circuits in Germany, also over a autobahn. And there's been many trials of having freight transport in an automated way. This has clear advantages because these cars can run permanently without a driver, and of course the frequency can be higher and the speed can be optimized. They can be driven electrically, but you don't have to. The problem is that it's not clear if then this wouldn't even mean that there's even more transport on the road, which would for our carbon output be very bad. Another topic is the individual traffic. So now I have a very cute car here. In large amounts, it's usually SUVs, which cost a lot. And the automotive companies, they declare that they want, in the coming times, service providers for mobility, because they see that through connecting, there's a lot of new topics coming up for them, and they can't be as well representative as they were before, but that they can maintain their position, they see themselves as service providers. Their aim, they're considering mobility as a service currently, also to pay with these cars. One part that's also quite interesting in the autonomous driving is the small buses, which are already starting to go across the country. So this one is from Bad Birnbach. In Berlin, we already have two pilot cars driving around, which usually drive quite slowly, but on demand, they can be called, and they can support areas in weaker infrastructure if they're well integrated. There's a quite interesting study on this done by the German Ministry of Energy, and it's about how to connect digital and interconnected traffic and how that model can generally work. Now I'm coming to my second point, which is the mobility as a service, also quite a large area in the interconnected mobility. There is a Swedish innovation think tank that wants to develop the ultimate system, so sort of a overarching solution that could be happening. So all sorts of traffic should be focused on one platform. It already depends on who's more oriented, if this is more for the businesses in this area. This is, of course, mainly for making money, so it's metric apps who assemble and division a number of services. There's payment method in one solution. That's one part, and the other players are sort of communals and public transport associations who decide on who can be set up to all the traffic methods that are currently possible, the new sharing systems for the bikes, for e-scooters, for cars. How can all of these be put together so that in the end it makes sense, that it can be orchestrated?
Dass es auch Sinn für die Gesellschaft macht.
That makes sense also for society.
Es gibt natürlich wirklich viele neue Möglichkeiten.
Of course, there's lots of possibilities
tatsächlich auch verbessern.
To improve traffic, even then when the payment is standardized. And currently, I'm sure there's lots of people who have lots of apps for all sorts of cars, for on your smartphones. This would all be reduced and go back. There's less different apps, and there'd be a very interconnected mobility, which would be easily accessible, which would even mean multimodal mobility, so you can select from a pool of different choices, but also intermodal mobility, so mobility chains. That means in short term you can switch between different modes of traffic, from the bike to the local train, back to another bike or an e-scooter. And because the algorithms behind this understand it, because they very, very easy to handle this. That's the vision, but it's very difficult to do technically. And as you know, there's lots of data putting together and lots of things need to be put together.
Ist natürlich, kann dann auch zu einem wahnsinnigen Kontroll.
And this can, of course, turn into a control tool, what lots of people will disincentive people to use it, because, of course, there's a financial data integration, as you can see in China, and with the social scoring, which is being currently established, which I would clearly see as not desirable for Europe. But of course there's insurance as being interested of mobility as a service concepts. Even the EU puts in efforts to build foundations on working with this kind of data.
Now I wanted to, so mobility as a service is for the different areas differently specified. For example, in the US, as usual, there is the focus on business. But they also, and their main focus is on cars, on automotive. So for them it would be beneficial to go for this approach, because they might be actually improving their environmental awareness.
Sehr gut integrieren in deren Mobilität. Weil halt da tatsächlich
so for them it's way easier to integrate this new way of mobility, because they have a large gap actually. And for their tech companies this is very interesting, so this is also for them quite So for China, this is different. There it's more about control. And so, yes, what I mentioned before, the social scoring system, it will be integrated into this one. In Europe, if it will work fine, it's about connecting regional transports. Because Europe already is very strong in the public transport sector. So here in Europe, it's more to save ourselves from the large business interests.
Urbanen Verkehre, vernetzten Verkehre sich da so zu positionieren.
So it's as I said before, more about connecting the urban public transport systems.
Konzepte entwickelt, wie das passieren kann.
And there are currently concepts being developed how to do that.
Bei der Mobility as a Service ist gerade
the mobility as a service
für die urbanen Verkehre wird halt gerade viel diskutiert.
For the urban transport, it is currently heavily discussed who shall be responsible.
Am spannendsten sind natürlich Konzepte, die sowohl die öffentlichen Verkehr.
So the most interesting concepts here are where the urban as well as the over regional transport systems are being connected. So, for example, Nextbike exists in several cities, so how could we interconnect this?
Oder gibt es Konzepte, die sich dazwischen?
Or are there concepts that are in between? So to distribute responsibilities and setting up an overarching transport system. So these are the questions. Who's taking responsibility, companies or the public? Here's an example.
Sehr interessant,
which I found very interesting during my research, because this is a very good example for connected mobility. During only 2 years, thousands of e-scooters have been distributed everywhere in China, in Europe, in a lot of cities. Which has been, and this endeavor has been supported by a large venture capital. Because they saw business models and they saw money.
In China, also das erste
so these is
2017,
the first startup was established in 2017 in the US.
Ich auch sehr interessant fand, dass unser Minister Scheuer gesagt hat,
what I found very interesting that the German Minister for Transport, Mr. Scheuer,
das eine sehr kommerzielle Form, die in den öffentlichen Raum gedrückt worden
was very much in favor of this, although it's a very business-driven solution that has been pushed into the public.
Interessant ist halt an diesen Geräten, dass die
what's interesting about these e-scooters is that the finance is global, but the actual scooters are manufacturers in China.
Haben die sogar Verbindungsingenieure, die sich mit den Herstellern zusammensetzen, weil sie festgestellt haben, die Fahrzeuge haben
eine
überhaupt nicht zum Pass, die müssen nach 3 Monaten
the operators have now been getting in contact with the manufacturers, because the e-scooters are not sufficiently long. So their durability is not long enough, so they have been getting in contact with the manufacturer to solve this, so that those scooters don't need to be replaced anymore as fast as
diesen Fahrzeugen total interessant ist, die Entsorgung ist nicht geklärt und man hat auch schon.
And yes, and connected to this, what is interesting about these e-scooters, that it is not at all solved how to actually recycle those e-scooters. So there are large amounts of old and broken e-scooters that are lying around on large heaps where no one knows how to recycle them. So the operators are currently trying to find solutions for this problem, in particular to recycle the batteries. But for now, there is nothing tangible that they actually offer. So I'm curious what's going to happen in this area of recycling. The particular question for Europe, is it actually sensible to have this large amount of transport devices, so bikes or scooters,
aus dem privaten Bereich im öffentlichen Bereich laufen müssen, sind halt natürlich schneller kaputt.
So because these publicly distributed devices will be broken way faster than private devices.
Sicherlich ist es auch ein Datenmodell, ein Modell gewesen, wie man an Daten kommt.
And the usage of the sensor data, it needs to be thought through.
Das sollte man an und für sich so nicht akzeptieren.
So it needs to be discussed whether it can be accepted, how this sensor data is being used, this data collection.
So, und jetzt komme ich,
and now,
zum, näher ich mich meinem eigentlichen Thema an, meinem Projekt.
And now I approach my project, so the topic of my project. Now I change
auf den Zustand von E-Bikes im, wie die aktuelle Situation bei E-Bikes ist.
Now I focus on what the current situation on e-bikes is. So a lot of things changed during the last years. They are actually all very well interconnected now. Just a moment, sorry.
Ja, in den letzten Jahren hat sich, wie gesagt, sehr viel getan.
So during the last years, a lot of things changed.
Die Uni Delft entwickelt.
The University of Delft
self-balancing system, was demnächst
developed a self-balancing system, which means that the bikes can self-balance actually. And the most prominent project is actually chainless driving, so fully electronically driving. So prototypes have been shown.
Die Idee entstanden. Jetzt ist soweit, dass die inzwischen möglich geworden sind und dass man die.
And now these prototypes are actually real and can be used in real life.
Unglaublich viele Sensoren jetzt auch.
There are a large amount of sensors on these bikes.
Inzwischen immer mehr Sensoren. Sie werden immer elektronischer, also es gibt elektronische Dämpfung, elektronische.
There is electronic dampening.
Bremsen, Gangschaltung. Inzwischen gibt es Bosch hat eine ABS.
And an ABS from Bosch. Bosch, sorry.
Bikes. Es gibt inzwischen
there are
die vibrieren.
Vibrating bikes, if you are too close to a person.
Man hat, ja, es ist, sie sind, man kann sie inzwischen sozusagen so sehen wie.
You can see them like cars, like small cars.
Und sie sind natürlich.
And they are.
Sie sind natürlich auch sehr kommunikativ. Sie haben Bordcomputer.
And they're very communicating. They have board computers. You can integrate your smartphone.
Der Nachteil ist inzwischen bei den E-Bikes auch.
The disadvantage of e-bikes, however, is that a lot of these components need power.
Ja, jetzt.
Now,
how
did I get to my project, which I will initiate now? I have been dealing with e-bikes since 2002, initially quite conventional, was dealing with conventionally. Did product development. And then I got my first smartphone, and I realized without Google, without the big companies, I tried the Fairphone, wanted to go towards open source operating systems on my phone, and I noticed without Google I'm not really able to do anything. If I'm not connecting to Google, I'm not really able to use my phone at all. I thought this is difficult because, in my opinion, everybody should be able to decide for himself. But whom am I talking to? Yeah, that was one of the aspects. In those days, Bosch was quite big in this market. They developed a smart bike with a board computer, and the data since 2014 went into the Bosch cloud. And in 2014, this was without consent, without any asking, they directly went into the Bosch cloud from the bike. Okay, I understand that from the point of view of providing the services is necessary, but at the same time a lot of private data gets onto the server, and I thought this is a bit of a problem. And this was one of my issues, why I said, okay, maybe we should do something different in this area. On top of that, I noticed that there's a lot of development in the area of 3D printing. 3D printing becomes more and more important these days for small series production, for trial production, and that a lot of plastics is used in this area, and that this is a problem with respect to the environment, that is really a big disgrace. I thought this is a very interesting technology, and so my idea was, how can I use 3D printing, how can I get it towards a more useful and more environment-friendly modulus of 3D printing, and how can I integrate that into the process of development? Since 10 years, so this is a third important point for me, since 10 years Bosch was in the e-bike area quite active. And they pretty much rule the field. They basically make it very difficult for other companies. So there is not really a lot of pluralistic. It's basically just one company. And they are the only ones which are active there. So I thought maybe we should try something else. So I don't really have a good idea in the software area, but I have some ideas in the hardware area. So I thought, well, maybe we should just try it. Maybe we should just develop an alternative vehicle, which is decentralized, which is open source, which is sustainable, which has sustainable components. Yeah, the idea was to start a project which is something similar to the Fairphone or to the Shift Phone in the smartphone area, which provides an alternative to the current developments. And when I started dealing with this project, I realized quite quickly, getting back towards the e-scooter issue, that it's not very helpful if basically the money dictates one particular area, one particular vehicle. So for me, what was very important for this project was the financing, to get a sustainable way of financing the project. For this, you have to contemplate to find something which fits the project, very important for a sustainable project, is to get a realistic life cycle calculation of costs. So what is important is that you look at the from the first step of the project right to the end of the recycling of the getting rid of the waste. What are the consequences for the environment? What are the fitting scenarios? What are the options to play them through to see what options, what are possibilities for the project. Especially for the hardware aspects of the project, my ideas were to start developing in silico on the computer. So this is like the first time I'm presenting this project here. If people are interested, I'm very happy to share more about the vehicle. So it's just to suggest the vehicle. It's not that I really want to build this. It's just I want to present this. I thought it's a nice idea. So getting back to the financial aspects, I think this project would get going with crowdfunding, with collecting money, with donations. My idea was really to develop this into a society type model for development of software. So the idea is really for the software development to start a prototype fund with which you can really start developing the software. And from there, we would go with the usual models, for example, like with Nextcloud, that the software itself is free, but support would cost something. For me, sustainability is really important. I heard the talk from Huber, and I found it quite remarkable that these people are also dealing with these aspects. That one of their concerns is that the software which is developed needs to run on these vehicles for 5 years. So it's very important that the software is fitting for the vehicle. Of course, important are licensing options, such that the licensing options fit very well with everything. So the question is, which foundations have taken over such open source projects? the cradle.
Für die ganze Hardware würde ich das Projekt gerne an Cradle to Cradle orientiert.
So for the setting of the project, I would like to orient it similar to cradle, from the cradle to cradle process. So the idea is that you really look at the whole life cycle of the project.
Die nachhaltigste Möglichkeit ist,
what is the most sustainable option for structuring,
wie man das dann am besten umsetzen kann. Ich
and what is the best way to get it done?
Weitestmöglich digital gemacht werden.
My idea here is to do as much as possible digital, to do the development, the scratching of the whole project digitally,
and
very important for open source and for a fair vehicle. To have give rise to a robust project which is as simple as possible and as clear as possible, especially if many people are working on such a project. It's really clear, it's really important to keep it simple and clear and use the most simple solution available. Very important is, since it's an e-bike, is the whole machinery to get the bike going. Question is, what do you use? Do you use conventional engine? That's probably the most fitting for this project, because developing something specific would take years, so best to rely to something conventional which already exists. So questions here, of course, what are the battery capacities? Should it be a vehicle for town? Should it be all around? Should it be useful for many areas? We really would need to discuss this, because this is very crucial for the whole design, for the setting of the project. Another question is with respect to assistance systems. Which such assistance systems do we want to integrate with the projects? Right from the start of a project, which ones we want to have in the project?
Well, interesting is also how we build the frame that's capable to work in different conditions. For example, there's the carrier for baggage that you can attach and take off easily. And there's, of course, the question, is it supposed to be a child seat? Can you put it on or not? How could you make that modularly? Directly while working on the design. For software, of course, that's where I'm not so strong, but this is really where, how do you get an open source system for a board, onboard computer? Which OS do you choose? I've seen a project, the Obico from 2008. Do you build on top of that, or do you try something completely new? I think we should look at basing this on what's already been done in the open source area. While my research, I've seen quite a few things. But there's a lot of things in my area of product development.
It's a good direction to take.
So, to be specific, I would say, where are the bases that we can go from? How can a Linux be developed? which works well, or develop Linux or an ROS can be developed, that it can robustly function on the system. Also, the embedded software needs to be rethought. So the onboard computer in the convention area, there are all sorts of bases from Bosch with the Kobe app and so on. I think you could orient it on something like that if you start working with open source, redeveloping something like that and integrating it. But then, of course, you've got to rethink what exactly do you want, how do you embed it. So if this is all working, then it's, of course, it's easy to should the vehicle will be working, then of course you can, from this bike, turn into a sharing device. So, for example, from the software perspective, from the hardware perspective, and then you can also embed it into other circumstances. But for that, of course, the basic development has to be done. This is why I want to quite effectively start small in Berlin, which is a wiki, which is the brain of the e-bike, which is a platform where everything can be connected to it already in open source area has been done, which can be like a library, what during manufacture in hardware can be used for this manufacturing process of this bike to create a basis for, and this is where I've already applied for financial support from the City Bike Berlin, where this platform could happen. And at the city lab, we want to do a brainstorming. What do we want to have on this platform?
Und wie kann sie initiiert werden?
And how can we initiate the platform itself?
Tja, es soll halt, genau, es soll erstmal so ein Sammelpool.
So this is supposed to be a collection pool of.
Wie, dass man sozusagen eine gute Basis.
How that we create a good basis for this e-bike project, so that this project can step by step developed. I think that many areas are quite open, so I'm sure it's going to take some time, so that in the end we can, have a robust, stable bike for the everyday use.
So, wir sind in Berlin auch dabei mit einer Gruppe von Leuten.
So in Berlin we are currently underway with a number of people to establish a
der sich sozusagen mit dem Bereich
team that with, from a theoretical perspective, looking with the whole area of bikes, e-bikes,
auseinandersetzt. Vielen Dank.
Many thanks.
Vielen Dank, Johanna.
Thanks, Johanna. And now we still have 15 minutes for questions. Please come to the microphone. We've got 1, 2, and 3. Without these microphones, we can't do anything. We also have a signal angel who, over the hashtag, will be questioning the saying the questions on the internet. So we start with microphone 2. Please no other referees, but questions.
The question would be, so will this really be happening with this auto car-centric environment that we are living in currently?
We just are supposed to not have it fail, and that's why I want to do the project, and that is the problem. We're moving towards this time. Currently, it's getting worse than better, and this is why these kind of projects are particularly important, because we need to find a way to do something on the road that's different. That's exactly true. But it's certainly not a hopeless situation, because in this area, there's a lot of things that are coming up. I was at the German Ministry of Environment, where they said it was about 5 to 10 years to see what, from a mobility perspective, we can be doing in the upcoming years. The key decisions will be taken, what is going to be happening later. So this is why I'm doing this project at the moment, to use this time well. Microphone 2.
Hello. Do you know that over 5 years there is an open standard for connecting e-bikes? Which has been initiated by the Next Energy EV. So 10 years ago it was still self-made stuff, and now...
Yes, I know this guy since my diploma, and this is one of the reasons I'm here. Yes, I was there in this development team. And that's also why I think this is a good idea. This project can become something, because I've got these connections. I've before this, doing my research, I've looked at it. Is this even possible? And I've also contacted all the people I know that I know. How is this realistic? Can you make open infrastructure for this? Can use the energy bus for this project, so that you have a CAN protocol for this vehicle. And there are a few possibilities, I'm sure. Any further questions? Do we have something from the internet? No, we currently don't. So microphone 2.
Good morning. I'm working for General Motors, and we have already built an open source car, like you showed, a small bus. So now my question, do you see potential to...
Absolutely, of course. So I think this is a very, very good. I think these are good possibilities that you now have through this interconnection. So right now, if you don't let yourself make crazy by the automotive people, now you have the possibility to find a true intermodal chain, to really have a multimode chain. And this is exactly what I think. This is a good time to develop this kind of project, because now we can say we know the other vehicles, and we can now build interfaces that exactly, for example, for your bus, so that it understands where this bus is heading. I think open source is very important, because on the Eurobike I already realized that, especially in the e-bike area, there is a very, very big interface problem because Bosch is completely closed off, and this is why lots of people are at a block because they can't get access to data and so on and so forth. So just to be working a bit in that direction, because this tiny project, which is a possibility to give a Linux and like Linux centered Windows, so this could be an alternative that you start small, 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 and then it grows, and then at some point it stops Bosch from completely owning the market. Because lots of people in this area say without open source we can't do anything, especially not in mobility. There's so much data and there's so many flows, without open source we can't do anything. Many thanks, Johanna. I think this is a very, very interesting project. I think all who are interested and have found your contact and can approach you, and I hope we could make it a bit more popular. And a warm applause for Johanna.
Thanks for listening to the